meant to them through the years, and how he's affected my life for the better. And I've poured my heart, my soul out to you. I don't know what else to do other than tell you that there is a real need here. And if you have to ban yourself from Starbucks for the rest of the year to be able to give a halfway decent donation, not being able to go out to dinner somewhere, then this would be worth it, folks, for Chuck to be able to have the ability to communicate with the outside world, to be able to write again, to be able to Skype, to get in touch with people from his bed that he's confined to for the rest of his life. He'll never walk again. He'll never see outdoors again, folks. You understand? I would want somebody that cares this much for me. And again, I can't look at him in the eyes without bringing this to him. I promised we would do it, and I'm asking you to please help me. Help him. That's what this is all about, folks. This is really what this is all about. Don't grow tired. Don't grow weary. Don't turn your back. Because the back you might be turning yourself, it won't be your own self. And paying it forward, folks, I am so convinced that if we turn our back on a need that's presented, and come on, be honest with you, how many needs are presented to you on a daily basis? A tangible one that you can actually watch, feel right there in your location. We're going to Facebook Live the whole thing when he opens it, how he reacts to it. You can see it. We're going to share it so you can be a part of this, feel a part of this, even though if you're not in the state of Florida, but you're a listener for the people. I mean, we are all connected as human beings. Listen, you don't even have to be religious. You don't have to be religious to believe that. Seriously, you can be an atheist. We're really here to help each other. At the end of the day, we're living this thing called life. I'm no better than you because I'm able to talk on a microphone. I don't think I'm better than anybody. I think everybody's got a part to play in this world. It happens to be me on the microphone doing this thing. Call the talk show. But we think it's important what we do each and every day. We think it's valuable. And I hope you do. You might not like this next story that we're about to talk about, but we will. Rosie O'Donnell, she's urging her female fans, okay, to start their own party. Their own political party. I'm not even kidding. And why is she doing this? Because the Democratic Party, apparently, and I know this to be true, there's candidates on the Democratic side who don't support abortion. She says women should form our own party. If Dems do this, don't you dare. Hashtag don't you dare, she tweeted today. Women should form our own party. If Dems do this. Now, her tweet was a response to Democratic Congressional Campaign Committee Chairman Ben Ray Lugin revealing there will be no litmus test for Democrat candidates going into the 28 midterm elections. No litmus test. Okay, so that's a good thing, you would think. Rosie O'Donnell, as we look to candidates across the country, you need to make sure you have candidates that fit the district that can win in these districts across the across America, Lugin told The Hill. That makes sense if the Dems are going to have a chance. So the comedian, she followed up, Rosie O'Donnell, fight the men who want to take away women's rights in our country. Oh, my God. Fight the men who want to take away women's rights in our own party. F you them for even considering it. Seriously? Hashtag stand with PP. So this is her rants. And her Twitter rants are usually saved for her tirades against Trump. O'Donnell, as you know, recently came under fire for sharing a link to an online game that allows players to push Donald Trump off a cliff. That was her latest deal. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to say, go for it, Rosie. Go for it. You know, increasingly what I have found, as people grow older, they become more conservative. Remember Ronald Reagan was a Democrat from California. Remember that. Donald Trump was a Dem, but now is a conservative Republican. We change. But here at For the People, life means something. Just because of inconvenience, folks, you don't just end a life because it's not convenient for you. And I'm sorry that Rosie O'Donnell disagrees, but it's my conservative belief that it shouldn't be our job to kill babies. We shouldn't be set up to do that because it's big money. No matter what they say, that's not there to make money. They make a lot of money killing babies, millions of them. And I think of all the millions, hundreds of millions, because that's the number, how many of those babies could have cured cancer, heart disease, AIDS, all those things? We could have been to Mars a million times over. I just don't think that we should be taking life. And if that's a religious thing, so be it. But I think when you don't have regard for the smallest, the most vulnerable, I don't think you really care about life much. We really don't. But parents, you have children. You ever witness a birth? Your granddaughter, your daughter had a baby. Can you imagine aborting that baby? It changes the way you feel and think about things. It reshapes you completely. I was always for life, me personally, but I've met parents that thought it was okay to abort them until they had one of their own. And they got thinking about the whole thing and they thought, I could never do that. And I don't support any woman that does. It might be somebody's right now, and I understand if it's whatever it's the law, and let them do it. I just believe that you're going to be accountable to a higher power, and I've met people that have had them, and they're not happy about it because a lot of the women live in a funk that it affects them emotionally, spiritually, and they never forgot what they did. And it was painful for him. I know it's not an easy decision. I've said this before for women, so any women listening, I know that's not easy. And I'm not bashing down on women. I'm just, from our perspective, you have to take a stand somewhere. And if you had to hold me to it, that's what I believe. Does it come with believing that there is a God that created? I believe that. God giveth life. God should take it, not men. And folks, there's no easy way to say it, but what these people do at Planned Parenthood is they kill babies. And can you be proud about that at the end of the day? I think it's one of America's biggest sins, what we commit, why God doesn't bless us more, and why a lot of our blessings have been stripped away, and why we have so many problems is because we ignore it, and we continue doing things like that. But I'll tell you what, Hell's Fury, Rosie O'Donnell, let her start her party. There are people that don't have regard for life or their own because they're nasty. And you think about some of their values. Rosie O'Donnell, do you think you want your kids to grow up like her and act like her, treat people the way she does? She's got the same nasty tone as Hillary Rotten Clinton has to her voice. It's not warm. And certainly not genuine, certainly not loving, and certainly would not be visiting Chuck Carter in a nursing home holding his hand or helping him with an iPad. Think about that. She wouldn't be the last person. The only person that she's there to help is herself. Me, myself, and I. That's it. Folks, that's not the world that I want to live in. It's not the world that I will live in. I will use my time more wisely towards endeavors that bear more fruit. And let her and her organization, whatever she thinks she's going to put together, I don't know if it's just a bunch of hot air or if she's going to concentrate on try with a new party or something, like putting something together to give her something, you know, to run against Trump. Who knows? But I'm certainly not going to give it much more credence than that. But there are people like her, and there's people that will cling to it. Just not my kind of peeps. I'm staying away. Okay, folks, I need you to go to our website at forthepeopleshow.com. That's where you can make a donation now so we can get up to that number. It's $70 right now. We know we can do better. And as soon as your donation comes in, we'll change that number. Are you going to be the one to change it? I think you can. Forthepeopleshow.com. And we'll be checking it 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And we'd like to get this money coming in as soon as possible so we can present this to Chuck at the nursing home, at Signature Nursing Home in Gainesville, Florida. So if you can go right now to forthepeopleshow.com, I would appreciate that. What would you give for a little peace of mind if you were bedridden in a nursing home? Today, we're asking you to consider a one-time gift for a man who helped so many for most of his life on radio, Chuck Harder. Your gift will help purchase an iPad Pro to help him reach outside the confines of his bed to the outside world. Would you lend a hand today? Just go to forthepeopleshow.com to make a donation and help bring some light into his world. Life in a nursing home is lonely enough, but being bedridden is tougher. It may not seem like a lot, because his mind is still sharp and his heart is wide open. Would you open your heart today and help a good man who means so much to us here at For the People? When we raise the $7.99 needed to purchase an iPad Pro for Chuck, we'll Facebook Live the video for all to see. Please give your best gift today at forthepeopleshow.com. That's forthepeopleshow.com. Thanks for your kindness, and God bless. Appreciate it, folks. Forthepeopleshow.com. That's where you can go and make that donation. See the iPad there on the website. And folks, we're all friends, aren't we? I appreciate every single one of you. Here's Michael W. Smith with his song, Friends.
We will pray the door, you'll live.